transcript of this letter and oblige. So they are making, they are stating very clearly that as soon as you receive this letter, within the 2 days of this letter, we want replacement, right? And we thank you in advance for your cooperation. It is assumed, it is taken for granted that your replacement is going to be made. This is also one of the courteous tones of making a complaint letter, that you thank them in advance and you convey assurance that we are sure that you are going to look after the mistake which has occurred due to the company's fault, right? And then the letter ends with yours sincerely, Madhurima Gupta, sales manager, right? So this is how a complaint letter is written. In the first paragraph, you have to inform about the problem, about the mistake which you have come across in a mild, courteous, gentle tone. Then you have to express an inconvenience which you will have to face because of the problem which has occurred, the delay which will be occurring now because of the problem, because of the mistake which you have come across. Then you have to appeal slightly to the supplier company's reputation, remind him about the sense of responsibility, and in the last paragraph, you have to talk about how you want the replacement, what kind of solution you are expecting from the supplier company. And you have to be courteous, you have to avoid irritation, you have to avoid anger, because the person who will be reading your letter has nothing to do with your angry or irritating tone. And if you do this, if you make an irritating or angry tone, then your problem will be looked after, but in future the person, the supplier company, might not be interested in making more deals with you, with your company. So this is all about a complaint letter. Now we will move to the adjustment letter. Adjustment letters. Adjustment letters are written in reply to complaint letters with two objectives to achieve: to satisfy your customer, to safeguard the reputation of your organization. When you receive a complaint, investigate the problem first, determine who is at fault, your company, your customer, or a third party, right? So these are the main purpose of adjustment letter when it is written. Basically, it is written in reply to a complaint letter. As in, when you receive a complaint letter, it is said that adjustment complaint letter should always be treated as golden opportunities to safeguard the reputation of your company, right? Because the customer had put trust in you, in your company, and therefore it had made orders. And the mistake, the customer has had a great inconvenience because of the mistake which has occurred due to your company. So therefore, you should treat the complaint letters always as golden opportunities. Now, there are two objectives when you receive a complaint letter which you have to achieve. The first one is to safeguard the reputation of your company, and the second one is to satisfy your customer by providing him or her or the company the replacement or the repair which he is demanding, right? So when you receive a complaint, what you have to do first is you have to investigate the matter properly. Factually, you have to find out the facts, you have to determine who is at fault, either your company, your customer, or a third party. Once you find out that it is your company because of whom the customer has faced a problem, the customer has had to make a mistake, has had to write a complaint letter, then you have to treat this complaint letter as a golden opportunity, and you have to provide the replacement asked by the person, asked by the writer of the complaint letter. Now, there might be various reasons of your customer's dissatisfaction for which they have written, they have made a complaint. There might be transport delay, poor packaging, lack of expertise, inadequate stock, or nationwide shortage. These are the various reasons for your customer's dissatisfaction which have led your customer to make a complaint, right? So you have to look after the reasons, you have to look into the matter carefully, you have to find out, and then you have to inform to your to the writer to whom you are making a response, right? So how would you respond to a complaint letter? So when you have to respond a complaint letter, these are the points which you have to take care of. First of all, respond positively to a claim. You always have to respond positively to a claim. Your tone should be as if you are agreeing to the claim. You are accepting the responsibility of the mistake which has occurred, which the customer has faced because of the company, right? So you have to respond positively to a claim. You have to try to gain the customer's goodwill by referring to your company's errors carefully. You should admit your company's errors, but you should be tactful. You should be careful by admitting the errors of your company, and you have to try to gain the customer's goodwill, right? You have to avoid lame excuses such as mistakes do happen, nobody's perfect. These are the lame excuses which should always be avoided while making a reply letter, while making a complaint, an adjustment letter. Right? Then do not promise the customer that such mistakes would never happen in future. Because in business, you are not sure that anytime any mistake may happen. So you cannot promise to your customer that these kind of mistakes will never happen in future. Right? Instead, you can say that we would ensure our best efforts that these kind of mistakes do not recur in future. So you can assure for the best efforts to be put upon, but you cannot promise them certainly and firmly that this kind of mistakes will never ever happen, right? And when the customer is at fault, you can either refuse the claim or simply agree to it. Once you have found out the mistake, and if when you found out that the customer is at fault, then either you can refuse to provide, to accept their claim, or simply agree to it. It depends on your company and the relationship which the two companies are having with each other. If the relationship is much more stronger, and if it can go ahead and it can gain so much of profit to both the companies, then it is the decision of the company to accept and to agree to the claim of the customer, although after finding out that the customer party, the customer company is at fault. So it is all about the mutual relationship of the two companies with each other, and thereby they will decide whether to agree the claim or not, right? But here we are discussing about how when the mistake is of the company, of the supplier company, then which kind of adjustment letter would be written. So there are certain guidelines of writing an adjustment letter here as well. First of all, you have to thank the customer for bringing the mistake to your notice. This should be the tone, and this is how the letter should begin. You have to say, you have to show the concern to the person who has made a complaint. You have to say that you consider their complaint very carefully. In other words, begin with a good attitude statement, providing necessary reference, right? So first of all, you have to explain about how you are honoring the how you are honoring the claim of the customer, right? Then the second point is, whether you agree, disagree completely or partially, tell him how you will remedy the problem. This is the most important guideline while making an adjustment letter. You have to inform him very clearly and completely that how you will remedy the problem. Whether completely or partially you agree or disagree, inform him very clearly. The third point is, apologize for the problem occurred, but remember not to use an overly dramatic tone. Of course, you can apologize for the problem occurred, but you don't have to be dramatic, or you don't have to make many sorries, right? And explain how the problem has occurred. So these are the guidelines of making an adjustment letter. You have to thank the customer, first of all, for bringing the mistake to your notice. Then you have to inform him very clearly that whether you agree to the norms, whether you agree to the replacement and repair demanded by the customer. And then you have to apologize for the problem. And at last, you have to explain the mistake. And then you have to remind him that how you are honoring to the complaint of the customer. Then admit your firm's fault carefully. Be tactful when explaining the claimant's role, if any, in creating the problem. Explain what action you would take to avoid such occurrences in future. Remind the customer how you are honoring the claim. Encourage the reader to look favorably on your company or the product in question in the future. Clarify your actions that your customers must take. So these are some more guidelines of writing an adjustment letter. You have to inform him about the mistake. You have to admit your firm's fault carefully. You have to be tactful, explaining the claimant's role, and you have to explain what action you would take to avoid such occurrences in future. You have to remind the customer how you are honoring the claim and encourage the reader to look positively, because this is the most important situation while making an adjustment letter. You have to safeguard your company's reputation, and you have to remind the customer as well that by honoring the claim of the customer, you are actually safeguarding the company's reputation, and thereby you are enabling, you are making the bondage more strong, and the tie-up should continue. This is the indicative message which you try to provide while making an adjustment letter. So we will now look at the specimen letter of adjustment letter. Sample of adjustment letter. Now, the letter which we saw in complaint letter, it was all regarding the padded and soiled mattresses received by the company, and they made a mistake. Now, regarding the same subject, how a reply has been made by the Apex Mattresses. So let us look at here. The letterhead is given. Apex Mattresses is now making a reply, and look at it. The letterhead is in printed version, therefore it has occupied the center position. Then reference numbers are given, then date is given, right? And then it begins like, "Dear Madam, thank you for your letter number TT472 dated 2nd February, wherein you have brought to our notice the flawed consignment. We are very sorry to learn about the inconvenience it has caused to you." So you are, in the first paragraph, you are admitting, first of all, you are thanking for bringing the that the customer has brought the fault to your notice, and then you convey your sorry. You apologize for the problem, the inconvenience which is caused to the customer because of your company. "In keeping with our tradition of complete customer satisfaction, we accept your claim. We also agree to bear the transportation charges incurred by you for returning the soiled mattresses to us. As soon as we received your complaint, we investigated the matter and found out that some of the mattresses delivered to you last week did not have proper and adequate packaging. Consequently, they have suffered these damages during the incessant rains when the consignment was in transit. We have dispatched 65 new properly packaged mattresses to you today. We are once again extremely sorry for the inconvenience caused to you by the delivery of soiled mattresses, but assume you of our best services in future. Please do send in your suggestion, if any, with regard to further improvement in our mattresses on receiving customer feedback in your area." So this is how a response is made by the company which has received a complaint. So this is how complaint and adjustment letters are tied with each other, right? And you can work on this. You can have an exercise on this. This was all about business letters, and we will directly come on the practice exercise of students. You can have a practice exercise on the basis of the features which you have discussed regarding complaint and adjustment letters. Please have a look on the question. As the purchase manager of Satyam Computers, 9 Naidu Road, Hyderabad, you had ordered 2 dozen personal computers from Hindustan Computers Limited, 140 MG Road. When the consignment arrived, you found some of the pieces in the damaged condition. Write a complaint letter to the sales manager of the company asking for repair, replacement, or compensation. And on the same situation as the sales manager of HCL, draft an adjustment letter. So these are the practice exercises of students on the basis of complaint and adjustment letters which we received today. These are the references which are being taken for the topic which is discussed today. Thank you very much.
Sandham, All Gujarat Integrated Classroom.
Satellite na madhyam thi jodti kadi, etle Sandham.